أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Surah Al-Fajr. In the name of Allah, the most affectionate, the merciful. Ayah number 7.
إرم ذات العماد.
And with the people of exclusively tall buildings of Iram. In the commentary it is mentioned, it should be remembered that the people of Ard are two in numbers. The first Ard and the latter Ard, Ard bin Aus bin Iram bin Sam bin Nuh, are the children of Hazrat Nuh on whom be peace. They are also known as Ard Iram. They were residing near Adan. The latter Ard were residing in Ahqaf, near Hadramut. Their people was Hazrat Hud on whom be peace. The collective story of the first Ard has been mentioned in the Holy Quran at two places, only in Surah Al-Najm and in this surah. Shahdad was from this Ard, who was the king of the world. He had his paradise made near Adan, which took 300 years to complete. Shahdad had lived for 900 years. Ayah number 8.
التي لم يخلق مثلها في البلاد.
The like of whom have never been created in any cities. Who were tall and handsome. The smallest amongst them was 36 feet tall. Or no settlement had been made like the paradise of Iram, which was constructed with the bricks of gold and silver, and kneaded clay of musk and ambergris. The pillars were made of rubies and tapas. Rivers were made to flow of pure gems, instead of stones and luxurious gems, and refulgent rubies had been laid out. Ayah number 9.
وَثَمُودَ الَّذِينَ جَابُوا الصَّخْرَ بِالْوَادِ.
And dealt with Thamud, who cut out rocks in the valley. In the commentary it is mentioned, the people of Thamud were the maternal cousins of people of Ard. They had established themselves between Arabia and Syria. They had established 1700 large cities between Hijr and the valley of Qura. They were experts sculptors, very tall and wealthy. Hazrat Salih, on whom be peace, was sent as a prophet to them. Due to their opposition and disobedience to Hazrat Salih, on whom be peace, they were destroyed by Allah Almighty. Ayah number 10.
وَفِرْعَوْنَ ذِي الْأَوْتَادِ.
And dealt with the Pharaoh, the owner of large camps. In the commentary it is mentioned, the Pharaoh had four believers pilloried, i.e. he had them laid on the scorching earth with their hands and feet spread out in the burning sun, thumping nails into their palms and feet. Amongst these was Hazrat Asiya and her waiting maid, the wife of Kharbil, who was pilloried, and her three children were slaughtered on her chest. For this reason, the Pharaoh has been called the one who pilloried.
Ayah number 11.
الَّذِينَ تَغَوْا فِي الْبِلَادِ.
Who transgressed in the cities. In the commentary it is mentioned, the people of Ard and Thamud had breached the boundaries of Tawheed, oneness of Allah Almighty, and began to indulge in polytheism And the Pharaoh broke the barrier of servitude and declared himself as a god. By Togha is meant to exceed the limits. For this reason, floods are called overflowing water. Ayah number 12.
فَأَكْثَرُوا فِيهَا الْفَسَادِ.
And then spread disorder therein. In the commentary it is mentioned, by mischief is meant misleading others, while by excessive mischief is meant either causing mischief over a long period, or to establish and create many types of mischief. This tells us that Allah Almighty does not mete out punishment for sin immediately. It should be remembered that the baser self first creates in a person a desire for wealth and luxury, then to obtain honor, then to disgrace others. These three things are the roots of mischief. Sharia has commanded to pay zakat and charity in order to curb the desire in the heart for wealth, made it obligatory to perform the salah in congregation in order to obviate an arrogance from the heart by standing shoulder to shoulder with the poor in the worship of Allah Almighty, by rubbing the forehead on the ground. Sallu ala al-habib sallallahu ta'ala ala Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. والصلاة والسلام على سيد المرسلين أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الصلاة والسلام عليك يا رسول الله وعلى آلك وأصحابك يا حبيب الله الصلاة والسلام عليك يا نبي الله وعلى آلك وأصحابك يا نور الله. One who recites Salatul Nabi loudly was forgiven. An old pious man dreamt a person after his death and asked, how has Allah Azza wa Jal dealt with you? He said, Allah Azza wa Jal has forgiven me. The pious man asked, for what reason? He said, I used to write hadith in the company of Muhaddis. Once he recited salat upon the embodiment of Nur, the mercy of both worlds, the beloved of Allah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. I also recited durood loudly. When other attendees heard that, they too recited Salatul Nabi. Therefore, Allah Azza wa Jal has forgiven all of us by the virtue of this act. Sallu alal Habib sallallahu ta'ala ala Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. One became dumb for not replying to his mother. It is narrated that a man was called by his mother, but he did not reply back. Because of this, his mother cursed him and he became dumb. Parents should better refrain from cursing. Dear Islamic brothers and viewers of social media, you have noticed that the one who didn't reply to his mother's call became dumb instantly. There are many Madani pearls to ponder upon, not only for those who are disobedient to their parents, but also the parents who curse their children. Especially those mothers should control their tongues who often curse their children by uttering statements like, may you perish, may you die, may you be afflicted with leprosy, etc. You never know that it might be the time of acceptance. And if the supplication is accepted and your child or your children really are afflicted with misery, then you yourself will be under much stress. Therefore, it is always best to supplicate only in the favor of your children. So, just as advice to Madani children, inshallah, if you're upstairs and your parents are downstairs, and if they call you, respond to them, labbaik, as soon as possible to avoid any curses. And those parents should do sabr, and inshallah, azza wa jal, if there's such tasks that the parents can do themselves at that time, then not to make the child sinful by giving him tasks to do. So inshallah, azza wa jal, as parents, we should think for betterment for our children, and we should make positive du'as instead of negative du'as for them. Ameen. Bijahin Nabil Ameen. Sallallahu ta'ala ala Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ya ilahi rahm farma Mustafa ki waaste, ya Rasool Allah karam kijiye Huda ke waaste, mushkile hal kar shahe mushkil kusha ke waaste, Karbala e rad shaheed e Karbala ke waaste, سید سجاد کے صدقے میں ساجد رکھ مجھے علم حق دے باقرے علم خدا کے واسطے صدق صادق کا تصدق صادق الاسلام کر بے غضب راضی ہو کاظم اور رضا کے واسطے بہر معروف و سری معروف دے بے حد سری جلد حق میں گل جنید باصفا کے واسطے بہر شبلی شیر حق دنیا کے کتوں سے بچا ایک کارک عبد واحد بیریا کے واسطے بل فرح کا صدقہ کر غم کو فرح دے حسن سعد بل حسن او بو سعید سادزا کے واسطے قادری کر قادری رکھ قادریوں میں اٹھا قدر عبد القادر قدرت نما کے واسطے احسن اللہ لهم رزق سے دے رزق حسن بلدہ رزاق تاج الاسفیاء کے واسطے نصر بھی صالح کا صدقہ صالح و منصور رکھ دے حیات دین محیے جافزا کے واسطے تور ارفا او علو و حمد و حسنا و بہا دے علی موسیٰ حسن احمد با کے واسطے بحر ابراہیم مجھ پر نار غم گلزار کر بیک دے داتا بکار بادشاہ کے واسطے خانہ دل کو زیاد روح و ایمان کو جمال شہ ضیاء مولا جمال الاولیاء کے واسطے دے محمد کے لیے روزی کر احمد کے لیے خوان فضل اللہ سے حصہ گدا کے واسطے دین دنیا کے مجھے برکات دے برکات سے عشق حق دے عشق عشق التما کے واسطے حب اہل بیت دے آل محمد کے لیے کر شہید عشق حمزہ پیشوا کے واسطے دل کو اچھا تلک سترا جان کو پر نور کر اچھے پیارے شمس دی بدر الاولا کے واسطے دو جہاں میں خادم آل رسول اللہ کر حضرت آل رسول مقتدا کے واسطے کر عطا احمد رضا احمد مرسل مجھے میرے مولا حضرت احمد رضا کے واسطے پرزیا کر میرا چہرہ حشر میں اے کبریا شہ ضیاء الدین پیر باصفا کے واسطے احینا فی الدین والدنیا سلام بالسلام قادری عبد السلام حش ادا کے واسطے عشق احمد میں عطا کر چشم تر سوزے جگر
Ya Huda Ilyas ko Ahmad Raza ke waaste sadqa ilaya kade chain iz ilmo amal afwa irfan afiyat is bilawa ke waaste.
O Allah Azza wa Jal, by the virtues of these holy saints, bless this gathering. Accept our Salat al-Fajr. Ya Allah Azza wa Jal, accept the tafsir of the Quran. Ya Allah Azza wa Jal, today we have learned to respect parents, to listen to parents, Ya Allah Azza wa Jal, and to be obedient towards them. Ya Allah Azza wa Jal, those parents who curse their children, Ya Allah Azza wa Jal, give them the ability to refrain from cursing. Ya Allah Azza wa Jal, if they've uttered such words, Ya Allah, of a curse, Ya Allah Azza wa Jal, relieve that curse, Ya Allah. Remove that curse, Ya Allah. And make the children, Ya Allah Azza wa Jal, free from curses. Ya Allah Azza wa Jal, give us steadfastness in deen. Give us the ability to worship you, Ya Allah Azza wa Jal. And give us the ability to earn halal, refrain from haram, to give zakat and charity, Ya Allah, to perform hajj in our lifetime. Ya Allah Azza wa Jal, give us good health. Ya Allah Azza wa Jal, give us that type of health so we can worship you and remember you and prepare for the akhirah by doing good deeds, by inviting Islam brothers towards goodness and towards the masjid. Ya Allah Azza wa Jal, bless the brothers who have attended the jamaat today. Ya Allah Azza wa Jal, brother Wasim, Kabir, Qasim, Ya Allah Azza wa Jal, Haider, Ya Allah, Usman, Ya Allah Azza wa Jal, and Sajid Bhai and Naeem, Ya Allah Azza wa Jal, some of the brothers that have left, Ya Allah Azza wa Jal, accept this sincere dua. Ya Allah Azza wa Jal, bless the mothers and fathers. If they have passed away, give them bakshish. Ya Allah, if they're alive, give us the ability to serve them, to listen to them, and to pardon any quarrels, Ya Allah, with our parents. Ya Allah Azza wa Jal, give us the ability to make our parents happy, Ya Allah Azza wa Jal, and give death with the iman to our parents and to ourselves in the beautiful city of Madinatul Manawra, with the vision of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the madhfan in Jannatul Baqi, and entry into paradise with the companions, with the Ahl Bayt, with Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, with our Peer Murshid. Ya Allah Azza wa Jal, grant us success. Ya Allah, grant our Peer Murshid good health. Ya Allah, Azza wa Jal, bless their parents and their tamam ulad. Ya Allah, bless their ulad. And Ya Allah, keep their saya and their du'as above us. Ya Allah, Azza wa Jal, bless this gathering and bless the Muslims of social media and the brothers and sisters who are listening via radio. Ya Allah, accept their sincere du'as for the sake of Karbala. Ya Allah, Azza wa Jal, bless Kashmir, Palestine, Syria, Yemen, and Turkey, and all the Muslim countries that have been oppressed. Ya Allah, remove this oppression. Give us unity, give us oneness, and make us strong. Ya Allah Azza wa Jal, give us the ability to worship you and to read the Quran. Ya Allah Azza wa Jal, Allahumma barik lana fi Rajabin wa Sha'ban wa balligna Ramadan. Soon we will be approaching Sha'ban and Ramadan. Ya Allah, give us the preparations to fast in this month. Ya Allah, give us the ruhaniyat of the fast. Ya Allah, the ruhaniyat of the prayer, the ruhaniyat of the Quran. Ya Allah, bless us with these gifts from yourself. Ya Allah, Azza wa Jal, a few days ago, yesterday, a brother has passed away, brother Nadeem Nazir. Ya Allah, so grant him a place in paradise. Ya Allah, so relieve him from the torment of the grave. Ya Allah, Azza wa Jal, he used to come to Fazani Medina and to pray Salah. He came with his brother to say itqaf a few days, Ya Allah, which I recall. Ya Allah, bless him. With the blessing of these, Ya Allah, bless him and remove any sins he has committed in his lifetime. Ya Allah Azza wa Jal, give us the preparation of the Akhirah. Ameen, Ameen, Ameen. Inna Allah wa malaikatahu yusalluna ala nabi. Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu sallu alayhi wa sallimu taslima. Allahumma salli ala sayyidina wa maulana Muhammadin ma'adilil judi wal karami wa alihi wa barik wa sallim. Subhana rabbika rabbil izzati amma yasifun. Wa salamun ala al-mursaleen. Walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.